Hi friends, so welcome to the class on customs valuation. So as per the latest developments in the customs law vis-a-vis GST, because we have got GST now, let me explain the valuation mechanism under customs. So in the last class we had some idea or glimpse about customs valuation. Now we will see further. See, actually the scheme of valuation, of course, the basic structure of valuation, there is no change, but of course from computational point of view there is some change. So first of all, customs valuation, if you see section 14 is the valuation section, right? And section 15 is for relevant date for rate of duty. Let us see the valuation mechanism as a whole in structure. So first thing is, whether you have imported or exported, what you have to do is apply transaction value. Apply transaction value. I put it in short form, but in the examination don't do that way. Apply transaction value. This transaction value is given under section 14. Section 14 defines the transaction value. 14.1 defines transaction value, which means the price actually paid or payable for goods when exported to India or imported into India. You know that. Plus rules, both for exports and imports there are valuation rules. So next step is, after this after value, find out rate of duty. Rate of duty. See, you are applying transaction value under same section 14 and find out exchange rate also, rate of exchange. You will find exchange rate also here under section 14. So find out rate of duty. This rate of duty, if it is imports, it is section 15. If it is exports, it is section 16. Right, and then you found out rate of duty. See, then go for assessment. Assessment is nothing but assess duty. Done. Job is done. But assess duty under section 17, that you can say final assessment. That is also final. But you see, sometimes it may not be possible to assess finally. If not possible, go for provisional assessment. Yes, you should go for provisional assessment. And this provisional assessment is under section 18. See the valuation mechanism as a whole. Section 14 valuation, section 15 or 16 rate of duty, and actual process of assessment section 17. If it is not possible, then go for section 18. It is as simple as that. You should know. Means the valuation mechanism, valuation scheme as a whole, if you see, it starts at section 14 and ends with section 18. 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. These sections, even section numbers, you have to remember. You have to find out the rate of duty. After all, what is assessment? Assessment is nothing but value into rate of duty. Is the amount of duty? So once you find out amount of duty, you got assessment. You did it. You have computed assessment. Assessment is nothing but computation of tax, computation of duty, that you have done it. Okay, but how about imports? Because imports are more important. Imports have a lot of importance. So we will see the imports valuation mechanism, imports assessment or valuation mechanism. Let's see valuation in detail. Imports. For imports, Section 14, of course, valuation, and Section 15, relevant date of rate of duty, and Section 17 and or 18 for assessment, because Section 16 is for exports, plus rules, very important, particularly for valuation there are rules also. How it works, let us see. So first and foremost thing is, first you see imported checkup. If you have yes, yes you have imported, then what you have to do? What you have to do is you apply transaction value, find value. Because mostly it is on the basis of value. Find value. How do you find Section 14? Plus rules. You are finding value. And next step is find if not possible. Find value with the help of. How you find value? Value through apply transaction value. You will finding value by applying transaction value. That is same Section 14 plus rules. So you are finding out value by applying transaction value. But sometimes if transaction value not possible, it is there, sometimes transaction value is not possible. So how do you say the transaction value is not possible? How do you find out? Very simple. Transaction value means actual sale transaction, value based on actual sale transaction. There is a sale transaction, exporter is selling and importer is buying and their price is available. That is transaction value. Of course, based on that, we have to find out value. Sale price is not transaction value, but transaction value is based on the sale price. With adjustments or modifications, the sale price becomes the transaction value. Done. But it is not possible that in every import that some transaction value is available. Why? Because you see, maybe you have imported free of cost, there is a gift, free samples, or you have received something as a charity. So there is no transaction there, there is no transaction value because there is no price. Sometimes you have received some imports are there just to participate in the trade exhibition or industrial exhibition. The goods have come to India for the exhibition. So there is no sale transaction, there is no buyer and seller. Transaction value is not there. Sometimes the goods come for repair or reconditioning in India. So goods which come for repair or recondition in India, there is no transaction value. So there can be n number of situations where the transaction value is not available, is not there at all. Secondly, transaction value is there. There is a selling price. There is a selling price. Selling price is there. But somehow it is not acceptable. How? Yes. There are conditions given under section rule 3. Section 14 read with rule 3 of valuation rules for imported goods. And rule 3 contains certain stipulations. Sale or price shall not be subject to some condition or consideration which cannot be ascertained in terms of value. And similarly, suppose there is a subsequent sale price which cannot be ascertained under rule 10. Like that, the transaction is with a related person, unless you prove that the relation does not affect the price. And price shall be sole consideration. If the price is not sole consideration, then also the transaction value is dismissed. So price shall be sole consideration, it shall be preferably an unrelated person transaction. The transaction should not be with a related person. Related person definition has been given under the rules, and other conditions are the rule 3. So if all the conditions are satisfied, okay, the transaction value is accepted. If any one of them is not satisfied, if it is affected by any one of them, that there is transaction value, but that is not acceptable. Once it is not acceptable, we have to look for alternatives. So transaction value is to be applied normally where it is not available, where it is available but not acceptable under law, then you have to switch to alternative methods. See the alternative methods. What are the alternatives? See, if TV is not possible, if it is not either not available or available but not acceptable, then apply alternative methods. Here you are applying alternative methods. Alternative methods are given under rule 4 to rule 9. Rule 9 is the best judgment method, last resort method or reasonable means method. Rule 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Of course, rule 6 is not a rule, but is only a clarification. Under rule 4, the rule suggests that you apply transaction value of identical goods. Under rule 5, you have to apply transaction value of similar goods. Under rule 7, apply transaction value of deductive value method. Under rule 8, you have to apply computed value method. If none of them is allowed, none of them is possible, then straight away go to best judgment method or reasonable means method or last resort method, that is rule 9. But remember, as per the scheme of valuation, you have to apply the rules from 4 to 9 in a sequence. You have to apply sequentially. Sequentially means you have to try 4 first, and then if 4 is not possible, then only go to 5, rule 5. And if the rule 5 is not possible, switch to next one. And of course, rule 6 gives a clarification here. What is the clarification it gives? It says, if rule 7 cannot be applied, you can skip it and try rule 8. Means you have to apply in sequence rule 4, 5, 7, 8. But if 4 and 5 are not possible, then you have a choice. Instead of 7, you can try 8 straight away, but with a written request. You have to give a written request to the department that I am not able to get data or information regarding computed value, deductive value method. So I will straight away go to computed value method. Then you can go to computed value method and try. So after computed value method, you go for directly. And if it is not possible, even if it is not possible, then go for best judgment method under rule 9. But remember, whether you are applying transaction value or applying alternative methods, it doesn't matter. One thing is for sure, that is, these are subject to adjustments under rule 10. Rule 10 adjustments are very, 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 very important. Rule 10.1 and rule 10.2. And there are a few changes under rule 10 adjustments mechanism. So based on rule 10, you have to make adjustments and find out value. And without that, it is not possible. So whether you are applying alternative methods, whether you are applying transaction value method, necessarily you should visit and revisit rule 10, and you have to take care of the adjustments under rule 10 and go ahead. Adjustments under rule 10. So it makes it very important, particularly in 2017 there were certain changes. Because of these changes also, we have to see the valuation mechanism, you have to revisit and you have to check it up. So in the next class, what we do is we will look into the alternative the valuation mechanism, and particularly adjustments under rule 10. Let us see that. Okay, we will come back to see rule 10 adjustments. We'll be back.